tell you guys today about my Shabbat, the day of rest in Israel. Because it wasn't really a day of rest for us. On Saturday mornings, I like to read my Bible with a good cup of coffee. So I did that today. I read Jeremiah 1. And while I was reading, the rocket sirens were sounding and my personal Bible study was interrupted and I needed to run to the bomb shelter to take cover. Thankfully, where I live, we have a minute and a half to take cover. So I was able to run to the nearest shelter on time. But actually, many families in southern Israel have only 15 seconds to take cover, to save the lives of their families and children. So if they are outdoors and the sirens goes off, if they don't sprint, they will not make it on time. Anyways, so I reached the shelter in my neighborhood. Many of my neighbors are actually religious, so many of them were spending the day in the synagogue, and as soon as the sirens were going off, they ran from the synagogue to the bomb shelter. And while we were inside the bomb shelter, we heard all these interceptions, literally behind our heads. The Iron Dome has been intercepting these rockets that were on their way to target Israeli civilians. After the siren stops, we are actually still required to stay inside the bomb shelter for extra 10 minutes for safety, but also to make sure that we don't get hit by shrapnels from the intercepted rockets. So after that, I got home to continue with my day and, you know, start cooking for lunch. And then another rocket siren happened. Can you imagine if this happened to you, your family, your children, rockets on your city? Over half of Israel's entire population ran to bomb shelters in the past few days. Many families are sleeping in bomb shelters tonight because we are dealing with terrorist organizations that are targeting us, civilians. On that note, I want to thank you. I have been receiving tens of thousands of messages from you, and I have to say that they are touching my heart. To see people praying for us, standing up for Israel and sharing the truth, that's exactly what we need right now. Israel will continue to defend itself and terrorism will be uprooted because it has no future in a peaceful Middle East. Thank you guys, and please continue to pray for peace in this region.